We are very happy to welcome you to our new channel about men's health and wellness. Here we will focus on the importance of preventing disease and premature aging, as well as how to avoid premature death. Whether you are 40 or 90 years old, or somewhere in between, and whatever your physical condition might be today, our message to you is that it is never too late to reinvent yourself. You can dramatically improve your health and well-being, and your sense of happiness. In series of short 10 to 15 minutes videos, we will in detail look at how to reverse your biological age and by doing that, explain what you can do to prevent heart attacks and strokes, cancers and diabetes, obesity, and many other common diseases. This video is the first part of our special series, Stay Younger for Longer and Slow Down Aging. Here we will dig deeper into how you can turn back your biological age. Before watching this special series, if you have not yet done so, may we suggest that you start by watching our first basic series, How to Hack Your Biological Age, the 10 Basic Steps to Reverse Aging. Now, let us start by having a quick look at highlights from our basic series. First of all, you must follow nature's rules and use nature's codes to talk to your brain. Rule number one tells you to move your body because exercise sends signals to your brain to grow and prosper, not to slow down and die. Nature's rule number two tells you to eat real food and to avoid fake food, which is important in order to follow nature's rule, which tells you to stay insulin sensitive. So yes, you must eat real food and only eat 1 to 3 times per day. By now you know that you must avoid all sugary drinks and processed food, and sadly, avoid most pizzas and pastries and cookies and cakes. And certainly, you must avoid eating French fries and potato chips and much more. And you may remember how your ancestors practiced intermittent fasting and made extended fasts during their hunt for food, often over several days. So yes, we recommend that you try the intermittent fasting and try extended fasting 2 to 3 times a year. If you already follow nature's basic rules, we're happy to say that you are on the right track to turn back your biological age. To help you progress and make a success out of your endeavors, we will in this series dig deeper into how you can stay younger for longer and how you can slow down aging. The first step we will take is to add a bit to nature's rule number one. 4 days a week, please ensure that you do serious aerobic exercise, whilst 2 days a week we suggest that you do strength training. On the seventh day, it would be good for you just to do some easy strength training or take a nice relaxing walk. However, we don't want you to exercise too much nor exercise too hard. We will look much more into all this, but let us start by having a look at our bodies. So, let us start with a few basic facts. First, biologically, there is no such thing as retirement or even aging. There are only two alternatives, either growth to live and prosper, or slowing down to die. Your body and your brain constantly wait for you to choose between these two alternatives. We know that you watch this video because you want to find out how to best reverse your biological age, so we assume that you will choose exercise rather than the sofa. Let us look a bit deeper into the reasons why exercise is so important. Your body is, of course, not a thing. It is made of meat and sinew and fat and many other parts that break down over time and have to be constantly renewed. For example, the muscle cells in your legs are completely replaced, one at a time, day and night, about every 4 months. Brand new muscles are replaced 3 times a year. The solid legs you have stood on so securely since childhood are mostly new since last summer. Your blood cells are replaced every 3 months and your bones every couple of years. So this is not a passive process. You don't wait for a part to wear out or break. You destroy it at the end of its planned lifespan and replace it with a new one. The net result is that you are actively destroying large parts of your body all the time. On purpose. The trick, of course, is to grow more than you throw out, and this is where exercise comes in. It turns out that your muscles control the chemistry of growth throughout your whole body. If enough of the growth signals are sent at once, they overwhelm the signals to slow down and die, and your body turns on the machinery to build up the muscles and the heart and the capillaries and the tendons and the bones and the joint and the coordination and so on. So exercise is the master signaler, the agent that sets hundreds of chemical cascades in motion each time you get on that treadmill and start to sweat. It is what sets off the cycles of strengthening and repair within the muscles and joints. and it's the foundation of positive brain chemistry. And it leads directly to the younger life we are promising, a life when you have turned back your biological age. A new life with its heightened immune system, better sleep, weight loss, and insulin regulations in it burning and improved sexuality, and of course a new dramatic resistance to heart attack and stroke and hypertension and Alzheimer's, and add to that, dramatic lower chance of diabetes and depression and much more. All that comes from exercise. But let your muscles sit idle on the sofa, the slowing down takes over again. At rest, only 20% of your blood flow moves through your muscles, whilst in a trained athlete, that flow rises with exercise to 80%. Imagine what is happening, rivers of blood flooding through your muscles with exercise, picking up the messages of inflammation and repair and of growth and healing, and taking them to every corner of your body. From the top of your head to the tips of your toes. From your heart to your prostate, fingers to knees. Every joint, every bone, every organ, and every tiny part of your magnificent brain is rejuvenated each time you sweat. That is the right balance, good breaking down triggering valuable growth. Now, with this important proof of the immense value of exercise, we will once again look at nature's rule number one, and this time add a little bit to emphasize how to exercise, and how hard to exercise. Rule number one, exercise every day of the week, for the rest of your life. 4 days of the week, do serious aerobic exercise. 2 days a week, do strength training. On the seventh day, choose some easy strength training or a nice relaxing walk. Don't exercise too much and don't exercise too hard. Aerobic exercise, as you doubtless know, is the steady exercise that gets your heart rate up and keeps it up, like brisk walking, jogging, biking, hitting the treadmill, swimming, bicycling, and rowing. Sorry, even though golf might be a wonderful sport for you, it is not aerobic. We are talking about steady endurance activity that elevates your heart rate and keeps it elevated. This brings us to our first ever recommendation that will actually cost you some money. Please buy a wearable heart rate monitor, either the kind of smartwatch you may have seen or the somewhat cheaper heart rate bands that you will hardly notice when you wear it. The good news is that those devices are not expensive, so please check it out. Now, let us assume that you have got your heart rate monitor and are ready for some serious aerobic exercise. Step number one is to talk with your doctor. This is not just a pro forma advice, it is real. See your doctor before embarking on any serious exercise. It is possible at your age that you have a condition you are totally unaware of that could make a sudden, new exercise program a grave threat. Don't take the chance. By now, you should be seeing your doctor once a year anyway. So again, do it before you start a serious exercise program. And then, in the same vein, let us urge you not to overdo it on the first day. Take it easy because your muscles and joints are probably not ready to go full speed ahead. Give it time because you are not going to turn back your biological age tomorrow, but by next year you will see great results. Step number two is to ask your doctor to help you find out how hard you can go burning fat and how hard you can go burning glucose, because that controls health and fitness throughout your body. Your heart rate is the only way to know for sure which metabolism is at work and which signals you're sending to your body. Your heart rate monitor is like the tachometer in a race car, you need to know your RPM to know when to shift gears. Your heart delivers more and more blood to your muscles the faster it pumps, and your muscles can extract more and more fat from that blood until you reach about 65% of your peak heart rate. Again, your doctor will test you and tell you what your personal peak heart rate is. As soon as you push your body a little harder, you start burning glucose in addition to fat, and you need more oxygen to do this. That means bringing more blood to the muscles, so your heart rate goes up. Any heart rate over 65% means that you are burning glucose, and that you have moved into a different metabolism. You have shifted into second gear. Your body starts drawing on the glucose stored in your muscles, feeding it into your cells to produce the extra energy you need to run and hunt. At some point, however, the glucose metabolism also has an upper limit. That happens at a heart rate of around 80% of maximum. For the 50-year-old, that is a heart rate of 136 per minute, at 65 it is 124. As with the switch from fat to glucose, the switch into this new stage, anaerobic metabolism, where there is not enough oxygen, has a ripple effect throughout your body. The only way to tell when you reach and cross these thresholds is with a heart rate monitor. You just cannot do it by how you feel. Now, towards the end of this video, let us have a quick look at how you figure out your target heart rate. Your doctor will test you and tell you what your maximum is, but basically, it is calculated by subtracting your actual age from the number 220. If you are 60, you will get 160. That is the theoretical maximum. If you are 75, your theoretical maximum would be around 145. In the next video, we will look deeper into how to use your new heart rate monitor, like finding your personal paces for long and slow walking at 60 to 65% of your maximum. Your high endurance at 70 to 80% of your maximum. And your anaerobic stage at 85 to 100% of your maximum. As you have seen, in this video we have given a first introduction to the importance of real and serious aerobics to efficiently reverse your biological age. In the next videos in our new series where we will dig deeper into how to reverse your biological age, we will look in much more detail at how to successfully use your new heart rate monitor to achieve incredible results. So welcome back, and if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do so now, and please also hit the bell to get notifications when we upload new videos. We sincerely hope that we have motivated you to get a heart rate monitor so that you can reap all the benefits of effective exercise in order to turn back your biological age. We hope you have found this video informative, and if so, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you for visiting our channel and welcome back.